The Rapid Raptor program stipulates that F-22 stealth fighters must retain the ability to deploy anywhere in the world within 24 hours. With the US Air Force's fast-emerging sixth-generation stealth fighter continuing to inspire international interest and the F-35 Joint Strike Fighter's global customer base rapidly expanding, it is all too easy to forget about the world's best air-to-air fighter, the F-22 Raptor. But this would be a mistake. In fact, even with the highly secretive sixth-generation aircraft already airborne and large numbers of F-35 stealth fighters showing up on NATO's eastern flank, the Defense Department is sending 12 Air Force F-22 Raptors to support NATO Allied Air Command at the 32nd Tactical Air Base in Lask, Poland, according to an Air Force report. Air policing will be the F-22's primary mission, the service report says, adding that the aircraft will be moving to Europe from Joint Base Elmendorf-Richardson in Alaska. The F-22 has certainly established its ability to deploy in recent years, particularly in light of the Air Force's Rapid Raptor program. The Rapid Raptor program, focused on speed, maintenance, readiness, and deployability, stipulates that F-22 stealth fighters must retain the ability to deploy anywhere in the world within 24 hours. The program prepares 4 F-22s and crew members with C-17 Globemaster lay cargo aircraft that can provide support, fuel, and weapons with the specific purpose of enabling a first strike capability in remote or austere places around the world. The F-22's readiness, Air Force officials explain, hinges upon a new software delivery strategy that sees incremental improvements, less as products for pre-planned, spread apart adjustments and more for a steady continuous pipeline of upgrades. This modernization approach, firmly oriented towards sustained readiness for combat, has been in place with the F-22 for many years now. Several years back, the Air Force and Lockheed Martin put a fleet-wide F-22 upgrade in place called 3.2B, which added new software to several of its cutting-edge weapon systems. The idea, as explained by senior Air Force weapons developers, is to enable a continuous and ongoing stream of upgrades and avoid having to wait for software blocks or increments, which can take several years to develop. When it comes to software, none of the old rules apply. It is a service and a pipeline today. We have to develop software differently. With the F-22, there has been a shift from a traditional acquisition program into a continuous stream of delivery. William Roper, former Assistant Secretary of the Air Force for Acquisition, Technology and Logistics, told an audience several years ago at an Air Force Association symposium.